Courtesied Chess. My name is Gary Ben.
And I'm Amal Min. Welcome to this month's NBT News and the first NBT News of the year 2020.
Bro, I was not ready to come back to school. They should have extended the break by at least one more month.
Bro, for real, bro. People are out here looking crazy. No one's trying, man. I think everybody's still hung up on the New Year parties.
That's facts. Yo, that reminds me. You got any New Year's resolutions you want to share with me?
Like what?
Man, I was thinking about, like, eating healthier. Maybe not, like, being so big.
Yeah. Yeah. That's funny, right? Maybe grow your beard.
Nah. I'm not talking about that, man, you know?
Oh, all right. My fault. But do you have any New Year's resolutions?
Probably just, like, be better in the basketball season.
That's what's
up. But here's Selvin with a story.
Thanks, guys. As the final year of the decade comes to an end, it's traditionally known to make New Year's resolutions. I'll be asking students what their New Year's resolutions are. All right, do you have any New Year's resolutions?
Not really, you know what I mean? I mean, 2020 is going to be, you know, drastically different, but, like, you know, I don't really see it that I should, you know, complete, you know, different things that I couldn't other years, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, another year, you know what I mean? So.
All right, so how was your 2019?
Well, my 2019, I think it was pretty eventful. Some parts were slow, but some parts I did things that I never thought I would do before.
Do you have any New Year's resolution?
Yeah, it's pretty broad resolution, but basically just to do what makes me happy and not listen to what other people have to say, because that's my 2019. I was listening to what other people had to say.
All right, how did 2019 treat you?
It treated me pretty well. Lots of fun and lots of memories that we made.
Do you have any New Year's resolutions?
Yeah, I want to go to the gym more and, yeah, just hang out with my friends a lot.
So how was your 2019?
My 2019 was okay.
Mine was too.
Do you have any 2020 resolutions?
No, not right now.
Why not?
Maybe later. Me too.
Okay, thank you. All right, so how was your 2019?
It was 2019. It is as good as it gets.
Do you have any 2020 resolutions?
No.
Hope everyone has a good 2020. Back to you guys in the studio.
Hey, man, those aren't half bad. Actually, some of those New Year's resolutions actually make some sense.
That's facts. I want to see if people actually, like, live up to it, though. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah. But you come to my game, you want to see me sauce it up? Like,
you know, is the team good?
Of course the team's good. I'm on it.
All right, well, we'll see what your teammate has to say about the season and if they're as confident as you. Back to you, Ryan.
Thanks, guys. I went and interviewed the basketball team to see what their goals for the season are and what their expectations are. Let's go see what they have to say. Now, how did you guys improve from last year?
We definitely improved on defense. We're more disciplined. And, like, we're all, like, a family now. Like, we're all, like, brothers. So that's something that we didn't have last year, for sure.
We got better as a team because we had a whole year to play together.
It's a young team, so everyone's been playing together, and we still have another year, mainly.
So what are your guys' goals for this season?
The goals is to win GMC, make it to foreign states, and just, like, keep winning each and every day.
But we want to win GMCs this year.
Yeah, same thing as him.
Now, what are your personal goals for the season?
Probably just, like, get better than I was the day before. Probably just score every game.
I want to try to get better as a player individually and, like, play better with my teammates.
Work hard every practice and don't let opportunities go past.
Good luck to the players this season. Now, back to the studio.
You see, man, winning everything this season.
Yeah, I might come to some of your games. You guys look all right.
Now you better come. I went to all your football games.
Bro, we're on the same team. You played with me.
Oh, man. But still, you know what I mean.
Bro, what's next?
Uh-oh. Principal Corner. Oh.
All right. I wonder what we're going to find out from Mr. Neller.
All right. Mr. Neller, you're up.
Oh,
this is crazy.
Hey, no, Mr. Neller.
Oh, my God.
What's up, guys?
How you doing? So, how was your New Year's?
My New Year's was good. I was, you know, it was nice and enjoyable, and I'm excited to be back at school for the rest of the school year.
That's great. As you heard, you know, Principal Corner is our favorite segment. You know, that's our favorite segment, right, Jerry?
Yeah, that's my favorite segment.
Yeah. So, how do you feel about doing Principal's Corner?
Outside of the jokes about my hair that disappeared in my 20s, I do enjoy it. I do talk, like, talking about different things that are going on in the school. and you know, being able to watch the newscast every month. I definitely do not watch myself, but I definitely like you know, being part of the school in this way.
Yeah. So, what's your favorite segment? You know, it's okay if you say my music review. You know, it's just, you know, I know it is, but I'm just want to ask you.
I have to say I enjoy almost all the segments, but Amon, you do a great job with the music review. If you ever do an old school 90s hip hop review, I would like to participate with that with you.
All right, so you hear it? You heard this? Next music review, we're doing 90s hip hop, and I'm doing it with Miss Anella, okay? That's, okay?
Yep.
Jerry, what you think?
I like it. That's a good idea. All right, thanks for coming by.
All right. I'll see you next month.
Thank you.
Wife, but
oh, I love my life and all that.
All right, man, we're down to our last two stories. I'm getting tired, man.
Facts, and they're both reviews. Man, I kind of wish I could have done a music review this month.
Maybe next month, bro. But how do you think Rome's gonna do?
I think she's going to do pretty good. She's going to put some real good artists just to watch.
Well, as long as they're better than the last artist you did.
Yo, I'm really about to tell Swing to get you off the set, bro.
Come on.
You could have done better than me?
I even now. But yo, chill. I'm just playing, man.
All right. Here's Roma with her music review. Let's see what she got to say.
How you shit?
What's good, everyone? My name's Roma, and I'm back at it again. Except this time, I hope you're into music because I've got a couple songs you'll be wanting to add to your playlist.
Yo, oh no. Yo, my vida, boss little. Call me when I'm feeling sick. Call me when I'm feeling down. Call me when you need someone to talk to.
The artist Melvito brings positive vibes with his music. When I first listened to this specific song, I wasn't too sure if it was my taste, and I was quick to assume that it wasn't for me. But after a while, the harmony soon caught up to my ears, and I really enjoy it. Now every time I hear the song, I just want to get my groove on. The artist K-Tronda featuring Tinashe on this specific song makes it a more enjoyable vibe. This vibe makes me feel like I'm on a runway with several photographers at the end waiting for me to strut down the aisle. And that's all, folks. Thank you for staying tuned. I hope to see you next time. And I hope you enjoy the music.
I'm not going to lie. That was a pretty good review. I think it's the best one we had all year.
Really, bro? You're going to say that? I mean, I'm not going to lie, though. It was pretty good. Good job, Roma.
Yeah, that's a good job, Roma. All right, now for the last story, the best one by far.
Yeah, man, everybody loves Matt's movies, bro. Everybody. It's definitely everybody's favorites. It's also my favorite, you know, other than mine, of course.
Yeah, those are my least favorite. Well, you might as well just hop into the story.
What? We're not going to hop into anything. Do you know what you just said?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I know what I said.
Right, you just said my stories are your least favorite.
Yep.
Are you serious? You really believe that?
All right, I'm just playing, man. Just forget about it. Let's hop into it. Moves with Matt, take it away.
Hey, Kylo Ren, should I review Rise of Skywalker? Hey, Adam Sandler, should I review your new movie?
Yes.
There you go. That's the answer.
This is me. This is how I win.
So we have Uncut Gems, another great movie from A24. And this film stars Adam Sandler as a crazed jeweler, as he has a really bad gambling problem that causes a lot of trouble for himself and the people around him. This film works mainly because of Adam Sandler himself. Now, normally in his comedies, he always plays the egotistical jerk that always gets his way all the time. But here, it's the same personality, but guess what? There are consequences for his actions. But Sandler brings such a charm to this performance that honestly, I can overlook how much of a jerk he is throughout most of the film. I mean, this dude, without spoiling anything, causes a lot of trouble for himself. That is not exaggeration. Remember, kids, don't gamble. But you know what? The other performances were great too, especially Kevin Garnett as himself. Yeah, the NBA player. And sorry, Michael Jordan, but now we have the best NBA performance in a feature. This film is anxiety prone to the max. Throughout this entire runtime, you're gonna be feeling the sense of tension, be like, ooh, like this buildup. Ooh, each scene gets more intense as the film progresses, and you know what? I was there the whole time. That's what made it so engaging. So overall, Uncut Gems is another great movie from A24 and a good film from Adam Sandler for once. So what do I give this film? Well, not to sound redundant, I'm giving this 5 stars. Yeah, that's right. 7 movies I've seen from 2019 get 5 stars from me. So that's all for A Reviews, and you all have a good day.
You know what, bro? I actually might go see Uncut Gems over the weekend. I might not. Depends on how I'm feeling, man.
I feel you. All right, well, basically, that wraps up our news for the rest of the month. But before we go, here's some upcoming events that you should consider checking out.
Check it out, man.
Tomorrow night, Coffee House at 6 p.m. in the Commons. Next Friday and Saturday, January 17th and 18th, the Alchemists are doing their theater review. Martin Luther King Jr. Day is Monday, January 20th. Friday, January 24th, is the SGO's talent show. January 30th, Mark and Period 2 ends. Friday, January 31st, is Human Rights Coalition's movie night. Girls Basketball has home games today at 7, Thursday the 23rd, and Thursday, February 6th. Boys Basketball plays Saturday at 11 a.m., Tuesday the 21st, Saturday the 25th, Tuesday the 28th, Thursday the 30th, and Saturday, February 1st. Swimming has meet tomorrow and on Wednesday, January 15th. Restaurant squares off on Thursday the 16th and Monday the 27th.
You come to my game, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna come. I got you. I got you, my boy.
Are you sure you're coming?
Yeah, I got you.
All right, that's it for this month. NBT Chess, my name is Jerry Ben, and I'm a mom maiden. Have a wonderful day, and we'll see you all in February, which is also Black History Month. Take care.
I wish there was a better way to do this.
Hey, you.
Who, me?
Yeah, you.
Thank you.
Hi, it's me, Anthony Sullivan from MBTHS Environmental Club. We're selling these silicone straws for $5 a piece. Hey guys, it's me, Anthony Sullivan from MBTHS Environmental Club. Did you know that the average American uses 2 straws per day, 11 straws per month, and 675 straws per year? Straws are pretty cool, but you know what isn't cool? Non-reusable straws. Don't be dumb, be cool! Oh hey, I didn't see you there. Did you know that purchasing an environmental straw reduces your carbon footprint and makes you a better person? You can pick one up from the NBTHS Environmental Club, selling for $5.
Good afternoon, MBTHS. My name is Ms. Raffano. I'm an assistant principal here at North Brunswick Township High School, and I want to talk to you for a few minutes about what we call our shared table program. It's an initiative that we've started in the last week, and what we're trying to do is to reuse food that hasn't been opened and reduce the amount of waste that goes into our landfills, but also to help out other students that may be in need of an extra little bit to eat in the morning, in the afternoon, or on their way home to school. So how the program works is we have a table like this, called the shared table, and we put bowls on the table, and we hope that after kids come out from breakfast or after they come out from lunch, if they have any leftover food that's not opened, they'll go ahead and put it in these bowls. For example, an orange, an apple, maybe a breakfast bar or some fruit and carrots and things like that. And they'll stay there on the table all during lunches. And then at the end of the day, we'll move those food items into our shared table refrigerator. which will then be available to anybody after the lunches who happen to be walking through the commons and might be a little hungry or know that they're going home and they just want something to snack on when they get home. Or even if they're staying after school for an extracurricular activity, they can grab a snack. So I'm asking you that when you go to breakfast, when you go to lunch, and you get some food that you're not interested in eating, if you go ahead and put it on our shared table and help a fellow student out. Thanks very much, NBTHS.